Hey everybody, Crystal Gamer here with the Caldera Camp Reno. So this is a little shack that is near this huge volcano in Sulani, and it starts out at $15,000, and I actually set a couple of goals for myself with this particular project. I wanted to do it in 50,000 Simoleons or less, and also keep it to base game and island living. So I just came back from my trip, and I had good intentions of doing like a big island living build or something like that, but then I remembered that my friends Mena and Simretha came out with this mermaid challenge. So I got all involved in this mermaid challenge, and I'm not typically one to do casts, but I kind of started going crazy on this mermaid challenge. And then before I knew it, half the weekend was through and I had no build or anything for my next video. And I was like, oh no, I have to do something. And then I started thinking a reno might be a good idea. And I found this shack at the base of this volcano, or not even the base, but it's really close to the volcano. And I looked at it, I said, this is perfect. It's a shack with a little outhouse. It's awesome. And I decided to keep it almost the same. I wanted to really limit myself the $50,000 budget for the whole thing. And it starts as 14,000. So I didn't want to go over 50 for the entire thing. And so I keep the house pretty much the same structure. I did expand the bedroom out, I think just a hair, and the front I expanded out just a hair, but for the most part I kept it mostly the same structure, which made for some awesome before and after shots at the end of this, because I was able to set the camera up pretty much in the same spot for the before and afters for most of the images. And so you can really see a transformation, which is awesome. I'm so into before and after images, like for anything. It doesn't even matter what, if it's architecture, if it's beauty, makeup, hairstyles, it doesn't even matter what it is. I love before and after photos. They just make me happy. So yeah, so I do those at the end, and I also have some before and after cinematics in the end. And it was an interesting project because I don't usually give myself a budget, let alone kind of a strict budget. And so I had to eliminate some things like high-end computers and things like that that I would normally include that I didn't include. And I had to be careful about where I quote-unquote splurged, if you will. Like one of the things I ended up doing that was kind of a little bit pricey was in the dining room, I actually ended up using 5 different rugs to make the pattern on the floor. And so that was a little bit pricey because each one of those rugs costs whatever they cost, a couple hundred Simoleons or something like that. So that was a little bit of a pricey splurge, but I couldn't find a carpet that I liked that fit and all of that stuff. And so, yeah, that was one that I kind of felt I needed to do. And then I do this shelf thing in the kitchen that was a little bit of a splurge just because I wanted one area that was kind of detailed a little bit, you know. But and the outhouse does get moved. It becomes part of the house, so there is an attached bathroom now. And the other thing that I figured out with this build that's really cool is there's this door that's kind of like the sliding, I don't even know what material it is, like a thatch type thing. And it's like a sliding door and it takes up 2 spaces. And to me, it very much looks like it should have thatch on both sides, that it should slide on both sides. And so I set it up that way. I used that door once in the bedroom. And so I set it up with the thatch on both sides. And then when I play tested it, it worked. Yay. And it doesn't do that crazy blinky thing. So yeah, it's awesome. It actually works the way to me it looks better as it's set up with 2 kind of back to back. I don't know, you guys can look and see what you think. But yeah, to me, I like that. I don't know, it seems to look like the way that type of door is meant to look to me for whatever reason. So yeah, so I ended up doing that. And my idea with this is that the entire thing is basically teak wood. And I lifted up the whole house as well. So it got put on a small foundation, not really high up. It's not hugely up on stilts, but it's a little bit higher than it was. So get up off the ground, get away from the bugs and all of that stuff. If you live in tropical climates, there's always a ton of bugs. So if you can get up off the ground just a little bit, it's helpful, I think. And yeah, I went sort of monotone with this teak throughout the entire house. And I think it looks pretty good. It makes it look a lot more, I don't know, a lot more high end, certainly than the little shack looked like. And so, yeah, so this is my thing. And I made the mermaid for this mermaid challenge, and it's hashtag mermaid makeover. If anyone is interested that's listening, and there's still a couple of weeks left on it. Actually, it's running through July 12th, and it's put out by at Mana Bush Buchner and at Simretha on Twitter. So if you're interested in looking at it, it's basically taking one of the sims that either one of them created and making it into a mermaid and submitting it and all of that stuff. And I think Retha is going to tour it on her channel, tour all the entries on her channel. So that'll be pretty cool. And I had fun making a mermaid, so that was kind of a nice thing. It just kept me from doing a really large build, but actually not a bad thing, because I'm super happy with this Reno. I really like this Reno, and I'm going to use it for the mermaid. I've already moved the mermaid in, so she's already living here. Of course, she spends most of her time in the water anyway, so she doesn't need a big spruced up place because she likes to spend a lot of time in the water, but this is perfect for her, I think. It's perfectly sufficient for her. And so, yeah, so I moved her in here already, and I've been playing it a little bit, play tested nicely, and it's going to be on the gallery as Caldera Camp Reno, and of course it's under my EA ID, which is CrystalGamer1, if you wish to download it. And we are already into the cinematics. I did a before and after cinematics, so we get to see what the little shack looked like before with its outhouse and all of that stuff, and then we get to see the cinematics of the final, and then after that will be the before and after photos, which I just love. I think that they came out really cool. So hopefully you guys do as well. And if you enjoyed this video, if you think that this is a cool reno and you like it, please don't forget to hit that like button before you leave. And if you're not yet subscribed, definitely subscribe to the channel. I do several videos, usually a minimum of 2 a week. Most of the time, I was sick at the end of last week, so I didn't do a second one last week. But most of the time, I do at least 2 videos a week. Every now and then, 3 or 4 if something big is happening, like a new pack comes out or something like that. And I do builds and pack reviews and pretty much all things Sims. I've done fashion shows and music videos and all kinds of crazy stuff, so all things Sims. If you're interested in The Sims, check out the channel. You might enjoy it. And yeah, make sure you comment below. Let me know what you think of this little reno. And thanks so much for spending the time with me today. I'll leave y'all to look at the rest of the before and after shots. And I hope to see y'all back again next time. Bye now.